Hi guys, this is teacher Ricardo, and this is what we are going to be doing next virtual class. As you can see, I have changed the presentation. I like this one better. Do you guys like it? Okay, let me know next class, okay? You can see secondary, we are going to talk about vocabulary and related to buildings. And all this information, I got it from your workbook. Okay, so let's continue. This one right here, as you can see, we have different words right here. I want you to take a look at them and tell me which one do you think belongs to atrium. This one right here. Okay, take a look at the pictures. Which one do you think it's related to atrium? And then pavilions, which one do you think it's pavilion? Okay, take a look at them and guess your best choice. Then towers. This is an easy one. Towers. Okay, did you find it? Okay, now architecture. Which picture represents architecture? Take a look at it. Did you find it? Okay, columns. That's an easy one also. Columns. Which one represents columns? Did you find it? Okay. Now, medieval. Medieval. Which one do you think represents medieval architecture? Okay. Take a look at the pictures. Did you find it? Okay. Good. Now, marble. That's also an easy one. Marble. And which one do you think represents marble? Okay. Now, the next one right here, tiles. Tiles. Which one represents tiles? Okay, you don't know? Okay, you are about to find out in a minute. Now the next one right here, beams. Which one do you think represents beams? Did you find it? Okay, now the last one, dome. Which one do you think represents dome? You don't know? Okay, now we're about to find out. Right here, atrium. These two pictures right here represents atrium, okay? And it's a space, an open space like this one right here. As you can see over here, we have an open space. Usually it's in the middle of the building, okay? The next one, pavilions. Pavilions, it's something like this, okay? This is a pavilion, okay? In here in Cuernavaca, we have one in Palmira, and we have another one. Yes, also in Palmira, the church. You know the church in Palmira? Okay, it's under an atrium. I mean, a pavilion, okay? And there's another one by McDonald's. There is a gas station near Chipitlán, Las Palmas. Okay, that's what I meant to say. No Palmira. Palmira is the church under a pavilion. And in Las Palmas, you can see another pavilion, okay? Now the next one, towers. This one right here, like the Twin Towers in the United States, remember? Okay, towers right here. Now, architecture. This picture right here represents architecture, okay? Now, columns. That's an easy one. We have different types of columns right here. Now, medieval. As you can see here, we have this building. It's almost like a castle. Castillo, castle, but it's the type of architecture is medieval. Okay, marble is really easy. This one right here, marble. This picture represents marble. Also, in English, you can call a canica marble. Okay, now tiles. We have different types of tiles, and it's very common here in Mexico, or if you have ever been to Taxco. They usually have houses decorated with tiles, many tiles on the walls, or you can put them on the floor. Now, beams. Beams. As you can see here, we have different types of beams. The ones in here are made of metal, but we can have beams made of wood. Okay, we have different types, and this is the to make a big structure. Nowadays, the new buildings are using metal beams. Okay. Okay, and the last one, dome. This is the dome from the White House in Washington, D.C. Dome. This is the kind of a structure that is called dome. Okay, and here in Cuernavaca, you can find them probably in churches. At the top of the church, they usually have domes. Okay, now you know the now you know this vocabulary. Let's continue with the next activity from your book. Right here. Complete the text with the words in the box. And as you can see, we have the same words. The one from the previous presentation. Now it says building of the week. This is the building of the week. The Alabama Palace in Granada is one of the best examples of Moorish, what? Which one? Probably, I will say, architecture in Spain. Okay? Along with the area of El Albaicín, it forms the blank space part of Granada. Okay? Now tell me which word you think is going to fit in this space. Okay? And you have to continue with this one and all of the rest. Okay, right here. I'm going to give you a couple of seconds to think about it to see if you have the correct answers. Actually, yes. Let's see if you guys have the correct answers. If you need to pause the video, do it. Because we're going to get all the answers next virtual class, okay? And now let's continue to this one right here. We have more new words. Portrait, tapestry, sculpture, mosaic, installation, still life, mural, sketch, landscape, pottery. Okay, do you know any of these words? Which one is going to be for number one, number two, number three, and so on? Okay, I give you a few seconds before I show you the answers right here. Mosaic, sketch, portrait, sculpture, mural, installation, landscape, pottery, still life. Okay, the one that we did not use is this one, tapestry. Okay, the next one right here, we're going to use all the words that we've been learning so far. Okay, now, right here, complete the sentences with the words in the box. Some of them may be in the plural form. Many people find painting easier than painting of people. Now, which one do you think is the correct answer? So again, I'm going to give you a couple of seconds to complete activity number 2 through number 8. Okay, you guys ready for the answers? You need to try to do it at home, okay? Before I show you the answers. And in case that you see the answers, you have to remember them because we are going to work with this next class. Okay, many people find painting landscapes easier than painting portraits, okay? And in the case of number one, I personally agree because to me it's very difficult to draw. For example, the nose, eyes, ears, that is difficult to me. But if you ask me to draw a landscape, it's going to be easier for me. Okay, so I agree with this one, number one. Number two, a lot of artists do a sketch of something before they paint it. Okay, and also that is correct. A lot of people first do a sketch. como el borrador. And then they painted. Okay. Number three, a mosaic can be made from small pieces of stone, glass, or plastic. The Bayeux tapestry tells the story of the Norman conquest of England. Tapestry, okay? If you need to see the image of tapestry, you can rewind the video. Now, number five, a famous bronze sculpture by Barbara Hepworth was stolen from a UK park. The next one, a still life, often featured things like fruit or household objects. Still life, okay? Whenever you see a picture with fruit on the table, that is called a still life portrait, I mean, painting. Number seven, a mural is often painted straight on a wall. Mural, okay? If you have ever been to Palacio de Cortés, you can see a lot of murals in there. Now, number eight, the Romans made a lot of pottery from clay called terracotta. Okay, so now you know many new words and you have to study them and remember them. Okay, now this is going to be your homework. Okay, it says, think of three buildings or works of art you have seen and write sentences about them. Okay, three buildings. If you don't know any buildings, you can find the information in Google, but you have to write it down on your notebook, please. And then you send me your homework through Classroom or email. Okay? Okay, so that's it, guys, for today's video, and see you guys next class. Thank you.